discussing the SN2 reaction. Now we will discuss about the SN1 reaction. Substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. This is what your substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. So as I already told you, SN2 reactions are those where the rate of the chemical reaction depends upon two reacting species, the substrate and the nucleophile. Now here in SN1 reaction, the nucleophilic substitution unimolecular, the rate of the reaction will depends upon the concentration of only one reacting term, that is only substrate. So here rate proportional to concentration of substrate only. The rate of reaction depends upon only the concentration of substrate. Because the rate depends upon only one reacting species, it's unimolecular and fast order reaction. Now this SN1 type reaction so is also called what or BN plus AN. Means what or dissociation of nucleophile plus association of nucleophile. This plus indicates the reaction process in two steps. DN is one step, again AN another step. In the DN, dissociation of nucleophile is what do? Association of nucleophile. So dissociation of nucleophile is the first step. Association of nucleophile is the second step. In the first step, the nucleophile will dissociate. That means, from the substrate molecule, the halogen atom will dissociate a nucleophile. In the second step, association of nucleophile and the nucleophile will associate with the carbonium ion intermediate form. So here in the first step, from the haloalkane, the halogen atom will dissociate, will leave as a nucleophile, leaving a carbonium ion intermediate. Then after, another nucleophile will attach to the positively charged carbon of the carbonium ion intermediate and finally will get the product. So if I write now, let's see if I have C R1, R2, R3, BR. This is your substrate molecule, substrate. Now the bromine atom will withdraw the electron pair towards it. Okay, this is called your dissociation of nucleophile, and we will get what your R2C R1 R3 plus, and this is the reverse reaction. It's a slow step SN1. So from this substrate molecule, the halogen atom will depart as the nucleophile. Okay. Now this is what? This is the intermediate form. This is the intermediate form. Step 1. So in the first step, the softer molecule, the halogen atom will depart its nucleophile, forming a carbocation intermediate. And this carbocation intermediate is having a planar triangular geometry. Planar triangular geometry. So we have what? C R1 R2 R3 plus. Now when the nucleophile will come to attack C OH minus. Now this OH minus ion can attack to this carbon from this side. This is called what? Front attack, and we can get here C R1 R2 R3 OH R1 R2 R3 OH. And if the nucleophile attack from this side, this is called what? Back attack. So because the carbonium ion, because the carbonium ion intermediate formed, having a trigonal planar geometry, it is having a positive charge here. Now when the nucleophile come, it can easily attack to this side, and also it can attack to this side, which was not possible in SL2. Okay, so when the nucleophile attack to the front side, we are getting this one, and when you attack to this side, back side, we will get what will be this one. C R1 R2 HO R3. Now this is called what? Inversion of contribution. This is called what? Inversion of configuration. And this is called what? Retention of configuration. Called what? Retention of configuration. So we have a product of 1 here and product of 2 here. So in this kind of reaction, SN1 reaction, we are getting a mixture of 2 product. One product with retention of configuration and other with the inversion of configuration, then we have taken an optically active halo alkene. So if we have taken an optically active halo alkene in the SN1 reaction, we are getting a mixture of two products. So this is called what? Racemic mixture. Okay. So SN1 reaction, it is substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. The rate of the reaction depends upon the concentration of only softer molecule. The reaction process in two steps. In the first step, a carbonium ion intermediate is formed with the slow step. The halogen atom depart at the leaving group. In the second step, the carbonium ion intermediate formed is attacked by the incoming nucleophile by two ways. From the front side and also from the back side. When front attack happens, we are getting this one, retention of compression of the configuration, and when back attack happens, we are getting the inversion of configuration. Okay. Now see, so this is the step 1 and this is the step 2. This is the step 2. Okay, two steps of the SN1 mechanism. Suppose I will take CH3O3CBr. OH minus SN1. I have CH3 plus. Then your OH minus again CH3O3COH. Okay. Now see, in this reaction, we have a tertiary haloalkane that gives a tertiary intermediate. This carbonium ion is a tertiary carbonium ion. Then after we are getting the product. And we know if in a chemical reaction the intermediate formed is more stable, then the reaction proceeds to give that intermediate immediately. And accordingly, the intermediate give the product, a stable product. That means the reaction rate is more. Where the reactant is giving a stable intermediate, the reaction proceeds in a faster rate. Here you see, this is tertiary carbonium ion is more stable, so the tertiary haloalkane give this tertiary carbonium ion immediately, and again it gives the product immediately. That means the rate of the reaction here is very fast. But if I take CH3 whole 2 CHBr, then OH minus SN1, will get what? CH3 whole 2 CH plus intermediate, then you know OH minus, you know, CH3 whole 2 COH. So here is a secondary carbonium ion. So because here we are getting a secondary carbonium ion, which is less stable as compared to tertiary carbonium ion. So secondary haloalkanes will be less reactive towards SN1 as compared to tertiary haloalkane. And like that also the primary. Okay. So if I take CH3 CH2 Br, OH minus SN1, then CH3 CH2 plus primary carbonium ion, OH minus, we get CH3 CH2 OH. So what you can say, the tertiary carbonium ion is more reactive, tertiary carbonium ion are more stable than secondary, than primary. That's why the tertiary haloalkanes give immediately tertiary carbonium ion. So tertiary haloalkanes are more reactive than secondary, than primary, than your methyl halide. So towards SN1 reaction, tertiary carbonium ion are, tertiary haloalkanes are more reactive. This is the just reverse of the SN2. In SN2, primary haloalkanes are more reactive than secondary, than tertiary. Whereas, you know, in SN1 reaction, the tertiary haloalkanes are more reactive than secondary, than primary, than haloalkane. This is because of this formation of the stable intermediate. Okay. For a given alkyl group, the order of reactivity is for SN2 is Ri more than RBr, then RCl, then RF. Let me see, alkyl iodides are more reactive than bromide, then chloride, then chloride. And now, for a given halide, the order of reactivity for SN2 is alkyl haloalkane more reactive, then primary haloalkane, then secondary, then tertiary. Already we have discussed now, because SN2 it is bimolecular. The primary haloalkanes are more reactive, then secondary haloalkane, then tertiary haloalkanes. And for SN1, tertiary haloalkanes are more reactive, then secondary, then primary, then alkyl haloalkane. Okay. This is because SN1 carbonium ion intermediate is formed and tertiary haloalkane produces most of all carbonium ion. They will come to secondary and primary. And this is the order of nucleophilic strength of HS minus, then Cl minus, I minus, OHO, then bromide, then chloride, then fluoride, then nitrate. So this is the order of nucleophilic strength that you have to remember. Next, your allylic and benzylic alloys are always preferred to undergo SN1 reaction, because in allylic and benzylic alloys we have the double bond cater, they can undergo resonance, that means they can form more stable carbonium ion. So when they will undergo SN1, they will form more stable carbonium ion. And SN2 is ANDN, while SN1 is DN plus N. This is what SN2 is ANDN. Association of nucleophile, dissociation of nucleophile. That means, at a time, for the nucleophile associates, then the halogen atom dissociates. Take place simultaneously. This is one step called ANDN. While SN1 is DN plus N, dissociation of nucleophile, then after association of nucleophile. First, the nucleophile dissociates, then the nucleophile associates. So you see, two step mechanism. Okay? We'll discuss a comparison between the SN2 and SN1 reaction mechanisms. Bimolecular. It is unimolecular. Okay, SN2 reaction is bimolecular, S1 reaction is unimolecular. In this case, the rate of the reaction depends upon the concentration of two reacting terms, the substrate molecule and the nucleophile. This is unimolecular. Here, the rate of the reaction depends upon concentration of only one reacting term, that is the substrate molecule. Takes place in two steps. So SN2 reaction takes place in one step only. That means the attack of the nucleophile and the detachment of the leaving group both take place in one step simultaneously. SN1 reaction, the reaction takes place in two step. That means the detachment of the leaving group takes place first, forming the carbocation intermediate, then the attack of the nucleophile takes place. Inversion of configuration takes place. Inversion of configuration takes place. That means the product obtained is inverted product. And your 100% inversion takes place. Inversion takes place. Here, racemic mixture is obtained. That means retention of configuration and inversion of configuration both take place here. Racemic mixture is obtained. Order of reactivity is प्राइमरी मोर रिएक्टिव देन सेकेंडरी देन टर्शियरी ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्टिविटीज मिथाइल हैलोजन मोर रिएक्टिव देन योर प्राइमरी देन सेकेंडरी देन टर्शियरी इनका सेपरेशन टू है ना। ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्टिविटी इज टर्शियरी देन सेकेंडरी देन प्राइमरी देन मिथाइल रिएक्टिव। तो इनका सब को SN2 रिएक्शन प्राइमरी हैलोजन्स आर मोर रिएक्टिव एज इनका सब को SN2 SN1 रिएक्शन ने टर्शियरी हैलोजन्स आर मोर रिएक्टिव। A transition state is obtained. A carbocation intermediate is obtained. A transition state is obtained. 5-membered. Here a carbocation intermediate is obtained. Hello, trigonal planar. Trigonal planar. And your sp2 have there. Okay.